we all think and feel very differently from the other person. And so is it right on our part to say that, you know, I am right and the other person is wrong? Also, is there, can we idealize something to be right and the other thing to be wrong?
Yeah, there is a very old story. I think we all have heard of that story of four blind men trying to feel a, you know, an elephant and trying to describe the shape of an elephant. And the person who felt the tail said it's like a snake, and the person who felt you know, leg said it's like a log, and you know, so on and so forth. So we all know that an elephant. So when we are searching for right or wrong or truth or falsehood, we are simply like those blind men who have our own perspective, based on our education, based on our sanskara, based on our upbringing, that we consider something to be right and something to be wrong. So we see whatever we see through the lenses that we have been given. And those lenses are made of our education, our sanskaras, our upbringing, and our experiences in this life and in the past lives. If my lenses are, let's say, made from concave and convex, two kind of lenses, right? So if I am looking at these flowers from concave lens, I will see a certain size of the flowers, right? And if you are looking at these flowers from a convex lens, you will see the size of the flowers to be different. Now, if I would tell you that these flowers are very big, you say, how can you say that these flowers are really tiny? So, are you right or am I right? Or are you wrong or am I wrong? From my perspective, I am right. From your perspective, you are right. So, to accept is very important. To know that this person is coming from a different perspective, a different background, from a different level of education, and you know, a different sanskars altogether, and not in this life, but in many, through many lives. So I cannot say that the other person is wrong, that is for sure, because that's his or her perspective and the way they are seeing it is right and the way I am seeing it is right. Okay. To give another example, let's say you are the person who trusts everybody, and you know, and your husband is the person who doesn't trust anybody. So you can say to your husband, what are you doing? How can you not trust people? That's so wrong. And he can turn around and say to you, what's wrong with you? You trust each and everybody? Huh? That's so wrong. So again, both could be right, both could be wrong. Of course, a person has trust issues because of the sanskara, the education, the experiences he must have had, where he has been betrayed by many times and so on and so forth. So he has got this perspective that this is not correct, this is how it should be done. And you may have had different experiences because of which you think, or different upbringing or different sanskara, because of you think that this is correct. So there is really, truly, I would say, no right or wrong. It all depends upon the perspective and the place you come from to visualize or see a particular thing.